Morning students, and we are back with the class of physics. We were dealing with that postural deformities, and we were in that chapter postural deformities. Here, correctly, already we have done their different postural deformities like kyphosis. They are postural or the portion out of the mat. It can be also like kyphosis back. Or similarly, scoliosis means okay, one shoulder, not a shoulder ligament, not ever type of position of what you say back. Similarly, lordosis, when the lumbar region is coming forward, the lumbar region is created in the forward direction, that is the lordosis. After that comes flat foot. What is flat foot? Generally, every individual. Every individual is having an arch in his foot. Generally, every individual is having an arch in his foot. But here, where the arch is missing, where the arch is missing, that is known as flat foot. Similarly, long knees, whenever you are walking or standing, when the knees are touching each other while walking, that is known as long knees. Both legs, when you are walking and the legs are pointed and the knees are going in the outward direction. Your knees are going in the outward direction, that is known as. So these are some of the postural deformities. Either can be by birth. Or after birth, like flat foot and all that, is brought from the birth onward. But slowly and gradually it goes away as the time passes. As you are doing, that foot goes away. But in some of the arch comes, in some of the knees, still remains. Those who are having flat foot, long knees, they are not able to participate. They are not able to, they can't be able to. That we have discussed why they, because if while walking, while running, your knees are touching each other, they are not able to keep the ball. But similarly, why you are having the round shoulders, why are you having kyphosis? When you are carrying heavy weight on the shoulders, or one of the shoulders, whatever if you are carrying, heavy weight on only one of the sides of the shoulder, so that shoulder will be bending down and another one will be coming up. So these are some of the causes that lead to postural deformities. Some of the postural deformities you will be carrying by birth only. But if it is not going, that means you are carrying it because of some of the causes. But there are some of the corrective measures. Which you should follow. And by which, if it is not going, you can use the, angle. So it is, you can use the angle of a particular deformity. It can be at least marginal. Little bit of improvement is there. So, when you are having kyphosis, yogic practices generally two types of yogic practices. One is Bhujangasana. What is Bhujangasana? Bhujangasana is cobra pose. What is cobra pose? Generally, you lie down on your stomach, and you bring your hands near to your shoulder, and slowly and gradually start to raise your upper body, and look towards the sky. That is known as cobra pose. When you are looking towards the sky, you can feel the stretch in the lower back. You can feel the stretch in the lower back. So it increases flexibility also, and it is a corrective measure for kyphosis also. Now chakrasana. Now you're lying on your back. Chakrasana, you are lying on the stomach. In chakrasana, you are lying down on your back. Now slowly, gradually, hence you have to stretch your legs. Now you bring your hands towards your shoulder, and gradually and slowly start raising your back from the ground. How much you have to बॉडी पोजिशन में साइड एंगल है, यू कैन पोजिशन दिस टाइप ऑफ पोज, दिस टाइप ऑफ पोज, सो दैट इज नोन एज चक्रासन. आफ्टर दैट कम्स इफ यू आर हैविंग लोटस, इफ यू आर हैविंग लोटस, व्हाट इज द एक्सरसाइज यू शुड परफॉर्म? When the in the vertebrae C type of position comes, that is known as scoliosis. But one should generally simple term, one shoulder little bit up and down. One of the shoulder is up, one of the shoulder is down. So if for scoliosis perform tadasana. Perform tadasana. What is tadasana? The hands fully stretch upward and come on the toe of the foot. Come on the toe of the foot. Generally come on the toe of the foot. That is known as halasana. That is known as tadasana. Come on the toe of the foot. After that comes exercises. Exercises to correct flat foot. You know what is flat foot? Flat foot is, you can say, there is no arch. Generally, those who are having people, users, those who are having flat foot, they wear different types of shoes also. For them, shoes are made different. Differently only, something is given. They under the sole, so that they don't have problem while walking. Well, generally, it is little painful for them for run and all that. But after the shoe is made in such a way that they don't have pain while walking. For flat foot, practice jumping on toes for some time. Practice jumping on toes, not heel. Jumping on toes. After that comes rope skipping. Rope skipping, again, you are jumping on the toes. Not after that, do up and down heel walking. Up and down heel walking. That means walk on the heel. Up and down. You are coming on the heel, then coming down. Up and down on the heel. You are raising your body from the heel only and bringing it down. So, do jumping exercises. Do skipping rope exercises. After that comes, practice jumping on the toes only. Perform walking on toes and walking on spiky rubber. Perform walking on the toes. Generally, do walking in the garden, but walking on the toes, not on the heel. After that comes exercises to correct knock knees. What is knock knees? While standing, while walking, if the knees are touching to each other, that means you are having knock knees. Again, the hair count, daily cycling for 20 to 30 minutes. Daily cycling for 20 to 30 minutes. Making a gap between the knees. So it is not, keep the pillow between the knees and stand straight for some time. Keep pillows between the, you are standing, but there should be a pillow between the knees. Keep pillow between the knees and stand straight for some time with both feet touching each other. There are special shoes, walking calibers or knock. There are special shoes. In what I told you, those who are having knock knees, for them generally the shoes are different. The shoes are different and they are made different for individuals. So those who are there are special shoes and walking calibers for training knock knees. They prevent knocking, thereby enhancing posture while walking or running. So these walking calibers or special they help prevent knocking the knees together. And what happens? Automatically your posture becomes more attractive. After that come, perform Padmasana or Gomukhasana. Gomukhasana is a cow pose. Padmasana is okay. You are sitting in a stable position, but the toes are on the knees of other legs. So that is Padmasana. Now after that comes exercises to correct bow legs. So here again two types of asanas are there. Ardha Matsyendra asana. After that comes this round shoulder. Round shoulders. Again, back is Bhujangasana as well as Uttarasana. Bhujangasana as well as Uttarasana. So perform these type of exercises daily, or you can perform these type of exercises daily, and you can improve. You can minimize the chances of different types of postural deformities inside you. Little bit of improvement you can feel after doing types of asanas. After that comes the last of this chapter. That is women participation in sports. Women participation. We have seen generally all over the world, but especially here in India, what we have seen that women participation in sports is very less compared to abroad and all that. If we are saying women participation is less, we are seeing women are coming forward and winning medals. But before few years, the women participation was negligible. They used to participate less, they were less participation. Either national tournament, internationally you forget to it. Internationally you forget after when first the point of game has come on him. How many minutes have you heard? PT Usha, Ashwin Chappa and all that hockey. We heard that similar like badminton, the Saina level. You have heard just now only. 10 to 15 years, when participation was less. Now the number is increasing slowly and gradually. But again, it is less compared to what it should be. If you are comparing with men, women are less in number. Why they are less in number? So we are building why they are less in number. Or what are the causes? That women participation is very less in number in India. If you are saying women participation is less in number in India, why? Generally, what happens? Parents don't allow the girls. Tournaments. We are seeing in district only. We are from our school only. From district only, we are seeing the swimming. If we are seeing only badminton, we will see okay. And if it was around 5 years ago, only 5 years ago. But now the culture is changing. Now the women are coming in more number to participate. Now they are coming in more number to participate. They are understanding the importance of sports and games must. Now the parents are able to understand how fitness is also important. If we are seeing during the COVID times, what is happening? Those who are fit, they are only surviving. By doing exercises regularly, by something. If you are playing, if you are exercising regularly, what is happening? You are immunity power. Compared to the people, those who are not exercising, those who are sitting idle, those who are sitting, sitting. It will be you will be having. If you will having, you will be having more about more. You will have the physical fitness components in you more compared to the other people. Suppose I will tell you, if I will tell an athlete to run for 200 to 400, he will be easily able to run. But if I will tell a beginner, okay, run. He will feel that after 30 meters only, 1 minute meters only. He will feel that remaining distance will be walking. So, why the sports participation of women in wrestling? That will be history will be living afterwards, but there are few other points. Lack of time to dedicate. Generally, what happens in India, what the parents say, the work of the girl is to work and what do you do to the girl child? To work in home. And to study. Now the girls are also coming to school early. Work at work in the 5 minutes of girls. parents are only not forcing them to play, so what will happen? But nowadays, either you go for CBC tournaments, the state also, the now girls are participating more number compared to what we used to do 10 years. After it comes, what happened, what we say, games and sports is for men only. It's for men only because they are having more strength, they are having more flexibility, they are more advanced. What do you say? The girl can't lift particular weight because they don't have so much of strength. But now, because due to different types of exercises, different types of techniques, they are coming in lifting also, wrestling also. After 2010 or 2005 onwards, we have seen that girl and women are participating in wrestling also. Earlier, there were less number of girls in wrestling and women also. But now, they are participating in the career opportunity they are seeing. Lack of confidence, lack of interest, lack of fitness and all that. These are some of the points which we will be dealing now next month. So, the next topic is that less participation. Of women in sport. For example, just now we are seeing start from a school only. You will not even know that if we are seeing the boys are playing much better, any game, girls, because they are not having any opportunity, they are not getting any opportunity, they don't want to come in front also to play. Why? Because of the lack of the knowledge, lack of the knowledge, then not getting from the parents also. If the parents are ready, send them anyway, they will participate in this team, but they will not go outside. They will not go outside to participate in high level. Why? Parents are told, don't go outside. Don't go outside the city. Then in the city, they are not looking. So these are some of the causes that you will be dealing with our next class. Okay, what are the causes why the less participation of women in their age? This is our last topic of the postural deformities and their characteristics of this chapter. This is the last topic which we will be dealing in our next class. Till then, take care, children.